This double welt pocket had tuck stitching all around the pocket box. Pretty durable, suitable for cold. Inside the pocket, there is a facing attached with pocket bag. First, I'm showing you the measurement of pocket welt and facing. This free cutting knife shows three sizes of fabric pieces. This 2-point is the pocket opening. The lengths are all the same, 8 inches. This smallest one is 2 inches wide, and the others are 2.5 inches. The biggest is 3 inches. The welt should be longer at least 1 inch at each side than the pocket opening. Look, all done, totally 3 sizes. I cut pocket bag as a rectangle first, and will reshape it later on. Pick up the 2 smaller pieces and add the fusible interfacing. Add interfacing on the pocket position and trace the cutting line. Also reflect this line on the fabric right side. Pick up the smallest welt and place it to the upper pocket position, and the another medium one at the bottom. I like to put a piece of paper under the sewing foot to prevent the fabric from being stretched. For a perfect look, 2 stitching lines must be exactly the same and aligned. Now I'm checking if they are exactly the same. It looks like one side shorter one stitching than another, so I made a little bit adjustment here. Now I'm going to cut the V shape between 2 stitchings. Cut the center line first. Then cut a V shape. The cut must reach the last stitch, but only one fabric thread is left to prevent the fabric from falling off the corner. Look, after cutting, it looks like this. Another side also used the same way. Turn over, check again. I found a tiny pleat here, which is because the cut still hasn't reached to the stitching end. So I had to cut a little bit more here. Fold the welt and press before turning it over. Fold the seam to another side. The seams are not going to be inside the welt. Make up the welt evenly. The width of both sides must be the same. Insert the triangle inside the seam. Make sure all fabric threads not showing up. For making it easy to sew, hand baste the welt first. I'm going to stitch the bottom welt first. Look, just this one. Turn over to the wrong side. Make sure the cutting collar lay flat without pleat before sewing. Exactly follow the original stitching to sew. When the needle gets to the cutting point, we have to catch every stitching there, otherwise the fabric threads will be sewed up on the corner. Now the bottom welt has been done. The following is to stitch in the upper welt. First, place the pocket facing over welt fabric, right side face down. It will be sewn with the pocket welt together. Make sure the pocket stays straight. Now I'm going to sew the small triangle. Try to make it lay flat without any tiny pleating. Reinforce this small triangle. Don't let the fabric threads come out of the corner. Do another one in the same way. I'm going to add tuck stitching all around the pocket box. The tuck stitching on Princess seam is 3/8 inches wide, so I will also match it on the pocket. Our hand had to go through here, so the tuck stitching on this side won't stitch with the facing. I fold up and pin down the facing to prevent the needle from catching it mark out the distance between tuck stitching and pocket. Unfold the facing I pinned before. Now I'm going to add the tuck stitching around here with the pocket facing together. I'm going to cut an angle on pocket bed to fit the slanty shape. The bed should be a line parallel to the center front. The pocket beds can be a little shorter than the welt here. They will be a line after sewing. Pick up one pocket bed to attach the bottom welt. Make the pocket bed a little looser when pinning and sewing, since this side had become bias grain. Add the narrow tuck stitching after attaching it. Now attach another piece to the pocket facing. Also add the narrow tuck stitching here. Reshape the pocket bed to fit the slant direction. Close the pocket all around. Okay, the pocket has been finished. It can be at over not all round, but it's optional. If you like my channel, please click the butterfly icon below for subscription. Thank you for watching.